Saturday, August 21st, Pacquiao-Nugas is brought to you by MP Promotions and TGB Promotions. And obviously, it was originally supposed to be Manny Pacquiao against Errol Spence, but Errol Spence suffered an eye injury. We wish him a speedy recovery, and we anticipate Errol Spence back sooner rather than later. But due to the fact that Errol Spence has pulled out of the fight, thus insert your Dennis Ugas, the Cuban bronze medalist, who will put his WBA welterweight championship of the world on the line, a title, incidentally, in which that Manny Pacquiao won from Keith Thurman back in July of 2019. So now I know the event is brought to you by and promoted by MP Promotions and TGB Promotions. I spoke with the president of TGB Promotions, Mr. Tom Brown, who is very excited and thrilled to be able to promote another event of this magnitude with Manny Pacquiao and your Dennis Ugas. Now, your Dennis Ugas is the kind of fighter who has always craved an opportunity of this magnitude. Pacquiao is looking to win the title that he feels was unjustly taken from him by the WBA. But now together, they collide next Saturday, August 21 in Las Vegas. For your Dennis Ugas, he spent 2 years away from the ring, returned in 2016. Since his return to the ring, he has gotten off and he's won 11 of his last 12. That only blemish coming a controversial decision at the hands of Sean Porter back in the spring of 2019. He trains under the guidance of Ismael Salas, and he's handed the first losses to the likes of Jamal James, Brian Perella, and also the very tough and durable Omar Figueroa Jr. Most recently, having defeated Abel Ramos in September of last year to capture a WBA title, he was elevated to super champion, and he will defend that championship on August 21st. He's from Santiago, Cuba, living in Miami, and trains in Las Vegas under the guidance of Ismael Salas with a record of 26 wins, 4 losses, a dozen of those coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your Dennis Ugas. Your Dennis. Your Dennis, how you feeling? ¿Cómo te sientes? Unmute yourself.
Jordanis, estás en mudo. Tenés que quitarle el mudo. Ahí está.
How are you feeling, Jordanis? ¿Cómo te sientes?
No, me siento bien, contento. Una gran oportunidad para pelear en un gran escenario y estoy muy feliz.
Martín?
I'm feeling great. Super excited to fight on this big stage. Ready to go.
All right. Thank you very much, your Dennis Ugas. Now let's talk to the man who will be standing across the ring from him, the three-time fighter of the year, Boxing Writers Association fighter of the decade. What can we say about the 8-division world champion? He has been involved in memorable, legendary matchups over the past 20-plus years that have thrilled fight fans all over the world, amassing wins over 7 current and future Hall of Famers, ranging from the likes of Oscar De La Hoya, Ricky Hatton, Marco Antonio Barrera, Eric Morales, also Miguel Cotto, Shane Mosley, and Juan Manuel Marquez, also being involved in one of the highest grossing prize fight of all time against Floyd Mayweather. In his most recent performance back in July of 2019, he picked up another Fight of the Year contender to his resume as he went ahead and dropped then unbeaten Keith Thurman in the first round on his way to a decision victory over Keith Thurman, handing him the first blemish on his dossier. His record, 62 wins, 7 losses, 2 draws, 39 wins coming by way of knockout. Even at the age of 42 years of age, this man is defying father time and wants to continue to fight at a high level. The Filipino senator from Sarangani Province, Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Manny Pac-Man of Pacquiao. Manny.
Hello, good morning, everyone. Thank you for this interview.
How are you feeling, Manny?
Very good. I'm ready for the fight.
Excellent. Well, I'm going to start off with a couple questions for Manny and your Dennis. Manny, for you, when they told you about the fact that Errol Spence pulled out of the fight, thus inserting your Dennis Ugas, I felt like it didn't take too long for the fight to get made. What went through your mind?
Well, first of all, I'd like to say I pray for his fast recovery of Errol Spence. Health as a priority is the most important thing. And also, I think I did my best in training, preparation for this fight, work hard at the gym. So I'm so thankful that it's not my hard work in training is not wasted. It's there's Ugas who are willing to fight in challenge this August 21. So good thing I can show my hard work what I did in training.
Your Dennis, when you got the call to fight Manny Pacquiao, how excited were you to be able to get that signature fight? And now you have that opportunity in 10 days time in Las Vegas on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view.
Your Dennis, cuando te dijeron que todo iba a cambiar para esta pelea y que vas a pelear contra Manny Pacquiao, ¿qué tan emocionado estabas por conseguir esa oportunidad de tener esa victoria que estamparía tu carrera y te permitiría comprobar todo lo que vos querés comprobar dentro del ring? ¿Cómo te sentiste cuando recibiste esa llamada? ¿Jordanis? Hola. ¿Jordanis, nos escuchás? Ahí está.
No, bien emocionado. Ante todo, quiero desearle pronta recuperación a Spence, pero pueda recuperarse bien, pueda regresar en 100% de su salud. Ante todo, quería decirle eso. Y la pelea, estoy bien emocionado. Estoy peleando contra uno de los mejores peleadores de la historia. Mucho respeto. Y es hora de pelear. Y va a pasar cuando uno enfrenta a uno de los peleadores que ha respetado toda la vida. Bien emocionado.
First and foremost, let me wish Errol Spence a safe and fast recovery. I hope he gets healthy soon. And as far as the fight goes, I couldn't be more excited when I got the call and I was able to find out that I was going to fight against one of the best fighters in history. Nothing but respect to him. And that just heightened the level of excitement for me. I'm eager to show what I'm capable of on Saturday night.
And yes, piggybacking off of Pacquiao and Ugas' sentiments, we wish Errol Spence a speedy recovery, but we still have a damn good fight with Manny Pacquiao, your Dennis Ugas, in Las Vegas in 10 days' time on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view. There will be electricity in the air at T-Mobile Arena. At this time, I'm going to turn it over to Andrew Roberts for questions from the media. If you have questions, raise your hand. And also, when they call upon you, make sure to unmute yourself. Questions for Manny Pacquiao, the division world champion and the reigning WBA welterweight champion, your Dennis Ugas. Andrew Roberts, take it away, my man.
Thanks very much, Ray. Our first question is going to come from, let's do Keith Idek. Keith, please unmute yourself. And you actually, bear with me. Brittany, you made me co-host. All right, excellent. Keith, if you could please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Thanks, Andrew. My first question is for Manny. Manny, can you explain to us how disappointing it was when you found out that Errol Spence was injured and not able to fight because you were so much looking forward to it?
You know, I'm not disappointed at all because my hard work in training is not wasted because your Dennis Ugas is there, willing to fight and challenge for the WBA championship. So still there. I mean, but I'm praying for Errol Spence for his fast recovery. Most important thing is his health we care for everybody.
Thank you, man. And I have one question for you, Dennis. Can you explain to us when you found out and when you found out that the opportunity to fight Manny presented itself, had you already found out that Fabian Madonna had suffered a cut and was not able to fight? Can you take me through that process?
Sorry. Bueno, contanos un poco de cómo fue toda la situación en la que te enteraste de todo lo que fue impredecible de la situación, ¿no? Porque te enterás de que Pacquiao va a pelear contra vos, de que Spence está afuera. Y además, en ese momento te enteraste también de que Maidana estaba afuera por un corte. ¿Cómo fue todo eso en ese caos controlado para vos?
No, sí, fue algo cuanto Spence, me dijeron que Spence estaba, sufrió una lesión, Maidana también sufrió una lesión. De todas formas, yo estaba listo yo iba a estar listo para pelear, yo estaba listo para pelear esa noche, estaba entrenando para pelear esa noche, y al decirme Pacquiao, eso fue el lunes en la noche, me dijeron lo que podía pasar, y el martes salió el anuncio, y la verdad fue todo muy, muy rápido, pues llegué al gimnasio y todavía no estaba procesando todo, pero estaba acostumbrado así a tomar pelea con poco tiempo de antelación. Y pues soy un peleador y esto es lo que me gusta y lo que hago, y estoy encantado por tener esta pelea.
I'm used to taking fights at the last minute. Nothing that's too out of the blue for me. What happened was that on Monday night I was training at the gym, like I was doing so far nothing out of the ordinary, and then I find out simultaneously that both Spence and Maidana are hurt. So once I heard that I was going to be fighting Pacquiao, I was game for it. I was super excited. And then I just continued on like I would have for any other fight because I'm more than ready to fight anybody.
Okay, great. I just have one more question for you, Dennis, and I'll turn it over to someone else. Can you just ask him, Martin, does he feel like by beating Pacquiao that he'll validate himself as the WBA champion because he was elevated into that spot?
¿Sentís que necesitas ganarle a Pacquiao para validar tu título de campeón, ya que de alguna manera fuiste elevado a ese título? ¿Pero vos qué opinas al respecto?
Sí, ¿me escucho?
Sí, te escucho, te escuchamos.
No, pienso que lo que pasó, a mí me elevaron a campeón en enero. Pienso que el sábado 21, el que gana ahí es el verdadero campeón de la WBA, y estoy contento con ese desafío tan grande.
Yeah, what happened was, like you mentioned, Keith, that I got elevated to being the champion in January, and whoever wins on Saturday night will be the true WBA champion. No question about it.
All right, thanks very much, Keith. Our next question is going to come from Erica Montoya. Erica, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Hi, guys. Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to talk with you. My question is for both. What are the complications of such an emblematic fight taking place 10 days from now? You have to adapt the way you train, your strategy.
Thank you, Erica. I answer first. In my side, I always consider myself a bipartisan boxer, and I like fighting right-handers and southpaws. So it's not a problem to me. I've been fighting with right-handed, so it's not going to be a problem. Thank you, Erika.
Bueno, thank you, Manny. Jordanis, la pregunta de Erika era, ¿de qué tanto te complica este cambio de último minuto en cuanto a la estrategia, a la preparación? Por ejemplo, Manny dijo que a él no lo complicó en lo más mínimo porque él está acostumbrado a pelear contra diestros y contra zurdos por igual. Pero en tu caso, ¿cómo te impactó este último momento?
Sí, es un problema de hacer los cambios. Como te digo, peleé hace cuatro años en Mayweather peleé con 10 días con Duloma cuando Poirier se quitó. Después peleé un día de antelación en un show de Fotamay. Estoy acostumbrado a pelear, peleé en muchas peleas aficionado con derecho y zurdo. Esto es solamente hacerle un par de ajustes y seguimos adelante con en la pelea.
It's not last minute changes are nothing that I'm not used to, and it's just about making the adjustments. I had to make it a couple of times before where I was told that something was going to change at the last minute, like 4 years ago. I remember I had to do that same thing, and I was able to adjust that same way. Also, a couple of years ago, same issue. So now I'm ready to adjust to whatever comes my way.
All right. Thanks very much, Erica. Our next question is going to come from Chris Matthews with KLAS TV in Las Vegas. Chris, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
All right. Thank you very much, guys. Appreciate you doing this. I guess for Manny, if you had to sell this, if for the fans who were excited to see you fight Spence, and now there was an about face in your fight and the other guy, as a promoter, as a guy trying to sell a fight to get fans, to get your fans excited about this fight, what would you say? How would you promote this fight to the boxing fans out there who now have to get ready for a different fight?
What I can say to the fans is this fight is not an easy fight. August is he's a champion. He took my belt and we have to settle it inside the ring. You know, I never take him lightly with this August fight, because August is he's a kind of fighter that you cannot understand it. So this is gonna be a good fight also. I mean, August and Spence is similar and same tall, so nothing changed. Different style. Southpaw and right-handed.
And then for Ugas, I'd like to just ask you kind of a question just on the opportunity that you have to fight a person like Manny Pacquiao, who has accomplished so much, and the opportunity to beat a guy like this. What does that mean to you?
Jordanis, ¿qué significa para vos el enfrentar a un campeón de la talla, del calibre de Manny Pacquiao?
Significa mucho, todo legado. Estoy aquí por mi legado. No tomo la pelea por dinero, estoy tomando la pelea por mi legado. Significa mucho tener todos los peleadores de ustedes tener una oportunidad contra Manny Pacquiao. Yo la tengo ahora ahí. Y esto es por mi legado, por mi historia, por mi país. Esto es una pelea más grande de mi vida.
This means the world to me, Chris. I'm fighting not for the money, but for my legacy, for my country, for my own story that's going to be told. That's why it's about to me. This is the most important fight of my life.
All right. Thanks very much, Chris. Our next question is going to come from Jeremy Harridges with FanSided. Jeremy, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Hi, Manny. Hi, you're Dennis. First question's for Manny. Obviously, the WBA has made a lot of moves with the welterweight title, rescinding titles, elevating titles. Does that provide you any extra motivation going into this fight?
Yeah. There's a lot of, people around me, reason that motivate me to win this fight. So, a lot of reason, but I will not say that reason. One thing is, of course, my family expecting me to win the fight, and the support of the fans. And of course, the enjoyment of the fans who are going to watch in the arena.
You're Dennis. I know that a lot of people are going to be looking at you as the underdog in this fight. What would you say is your biggest weapon in this fight, and why should people be looking at you as not an underdog?
¿Por qué la gente
no te debería ver como un, como que vas de, en Argentina decimos que vas de punto y no de banca, o sea, de por qué no te deberían considerar alguien que va de menos, o sea, por qué deberías ser considerado el favorito.
Luis, repite la pregunta.
¿Por qué? O sea, obviamente en esta pelea no te consideran el favorito, pero ¿por qué crees que están equivocados? ¿Por qué Yordanis Lucas debería ser el favorito en esta pelea?
No, soy un peleador que viene peleando, regresé hace 5 años. Hace 5 años subí a 147, tenía 15-3. Estaba peleado con lo mejor que se me ha puesto. Debía ser un campeón en el 2019 cuando me jugaron la pelea con Porte. Seguí peleando, gané el campeonato. Aquí estaba fuera del deporte y me elevaron a supercampeón. Soy un campeón. Siento, sí, Pacquiao es favorito. Tiene una gran historia. Yo soy un peleador que viene a ganar y a sorprender el mundo esa noche.
Well, look, I'm well aware that Pacquiao is the favorite, but at the same time, I'm a champion. Ever since I came back 5 years ago, I have overcome so much. I have had fights stolen from me. I've fought really strong opponents, and I have just gone through everything in order to get to where I am today. So even though Manny is the favorite, I have full confidence in myself and my ability to come out with a victory on Saturday night.
Thank you, gentlemen, and best of luck.
All right. Thanks, Jeremy. Our next question is going to come from Dan Rayfield. Dan, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Thank you very much, guys. Appreciate that. Ordenis, my first question is for you, Martin, if you could ask him. He had a 2-year layoff between 2014 and 16 after he had suffered a couple of losses and then came back and moved up. And I wondered, first off, if he could just talk about a little bit what he was doing during the 2-year layoff in terms of his mentality of we would fight again. And if at that time, which I think was probably a low point in his career, you'd ever imagine that not only would have these types of opportunities, have a belt and, you know, be fighting a legend like Manny Pacquiao.
Okay, so it's a 2-for-1 question, right? First, what he was doing, and then what it means to him, like, to have this opportunity at this point in his career, correct?
Right. In other words, did he ever think at the time of that layoff, in that downtime, that he could be back in this level of an event?
Bueno, Yordanis, contanos un poco lo que hiciste durante ese parate entre 2014 y 2016 y también si en aquel entonces te imaginabas que 5 años después estarías donde estás ahora, peleando contra Pacquiao por el título.
No, en 2014 tuve 2 derrotas, me fui con mi casa, tuve 2 años y medio fuera, haciendo otras cosas, tuve mi hijo, organicé y sabía que podía dar mucho. No pensé que iba a pelear con Pacquiao defendiendo un campeonato. Eso nunca lo pasé, pero sí pensé que podía hacer mucho en el deporte. Y eso es lo que yo he hecho desde que regresé. Siento que he sido uno de los peleadores más activos y mejores peleadores en los últimos años.
Well, Dan, when I came back, when I went away from boxing after a couple of losses in 2014, I focused on family. I wanted to spend time with my kid more than anything, my son. That's what was most important to him. And to be honest with you, back then, I would have never thought that 7 years later, I would be fighting against Manny Pacquiao, defending a title. But, you know, in the past 5 years, I have been one of the most active, one of the most successful, one of the most prominent boxers out there. And I'm here to prove myself once again.
Oh, very good. And I had a question also for Manny. Manny, it's good to talk to you. Manny, I know you addressed a little earlier Keith's question about the WBA situation, but I wonder, in any way, do you feel like this should be your title defense? I mean, you won the title against Thurman, and now they tell you you're not the actual WBA champion, and that it should, in fact, be a title defense for you, and that does that in any way upset you, that technically you're the challenger here?
I think this fight is going to be the finals, going to be hold the belt, and it's happening this way, so this is good. I mean, I'm so excited for this championship fight. I don't care if this is the champion or I'm the champion or no, but let's finish this fight first, and then we will see who's the title holder.
Okay, and if you win the fight, I don't even know if you realize this. When you beat Keith Thurman at age 40, you became the oldest fighter in the history of boxing to win a welterweight championship. Now that you're technically the challenger here, if you beat Ugas at age 42, you'll break your own record. What would that mean to you to have such another feather in your cap?
That's very good because I'm myself breaking my own record.
You like that, right?
I like that. Making history.
Great. Thanks, Dan. Our next question is going to come from Farah Parrett with Telemundo. Farah, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Yes, thank you so much. So Manny Pacquiao, this is another fight in your amazing career. What do you would like for people to think about Manny Pacquiao, not only as a boxer, but in your personal life and career? What do you want people to remember you as?
The most important thing that I want people to remember me is Manny Pacquiao is a friendly, is a nice guy and an inspiration to everyone. Not only inside the ring, but outside the ring, as a human, especially showing the love to each other and passion, compassion to each other. So that's one I want them to remember me. Not only in boxing.
Thank you. And for Ugas, me gustaría saber. ¿Qué representa para la comunidad cubana ahora mismo tener a una figura de su país en estos tiempos que necesita apoyo moral, espiritual, política? Pelear con Manny Pacquiao, ¿qué significa para ti y qué mensaje tú quisieras a la comunidad, no solamente del boxeo, sino a la comunidad cubana?
Sí, todo el mundo sabe que soy un peleador por los derechos de mi país. Soy un peleador contra la dictadura de mi país. Todo el mundo sabe que levanto mi voz muy alta contra eso todo el tiempo. Y esta pelea es una plataforma increíble para yo lanzar lo que tenemos los cubanos, que es patria y vida, y pedirle un mejor país, libertad para todos los presos políticos. Y esta pelea es una oportunidad increíble para esas cosas.
The question from Farah was, what does it mean to you to be fighting against Manny Pacquiao, not just for yourself, but for the people in your country, in Cuba, that are going through hard times? And Jordani replied that, you know, I'm a fighter not only inside the ring, but outside of it. I fight against the leadership. I fight for the freedom of my people. I fight for the freedom of the political prisoners that are in jail right now. And, you know, there's a saying in Cuba called patria y vida. It's basically country and life, right? So that's who I fight for, my people. That's the most important thing to me. And I hope everyone is safe and, you know, fighting for their freedom right now. And I'll be fighting for them on Saturday.
All right. Thank you, Farah. Our next question is going to come from Manouk Kopian with the LA Times. Manouk, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Hi, Manny. You're taking this fight on 11 days notice. And as everyone knows, you became a name overnight when you took a fight on short notice against Lilo Laguava in 2001. Are you concerned that repeat a version of history against you?
No, I'm not worried about that because it's happened that way that Jordanis Ugas is under card. So my case before is I wasn't in the card. I wasn't in the card. So I'm just a substitute on that fight too. I think this time around, I know Ugas is also prepared for this fight because he's under card. So he's in training. Good. It happened. You know, we cannot avoid it. What's happening right now?
Did you consider at any point canceling the fight altogether, or you did not want to waste any more time, or more importantly, a training camp at this point of your career?
Considering cancel the fight. Yeah, I mean, if there's no Ugas in the undercard, there's no the same weight in my undercard. I think probably the fight will be canceled, but it happened that way. It's a good thing that Ugas is the same weight in welterweight division and under his undercard. So it happened that there's an injury in our opponent. So why we don't fight each other? So to settle down, who's the WBA champion? So that's the question.
Thank you very much. All right, thanks, Manu. Our next question is going to come from Katia Castorena with ESPN Deportes. Katia, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Thank you. First for Manny. Manny, it's been 25 months since we last saw you on the ring. So what can we expect from you and how do you feel physically?
I'm excited. So excited for the coming fight on August 21. It's been a while that I didn't have a fight. So this is going to be exciting and can't wait.
Y Jordanis, ¿qué versión esperas de Manny también en el plano físico por el tema de la edad y por el tema de que hace poco más de dos años desde la última vez que lo vimos arriba del ring?
Jordanis?
Sí.
¿Escuchaste la pregunta?
Sí, escuché. No, espero el mejor Manny Pacquiao. Me estoy preparando para el mejor Manny Pacquiao. Un peleador que siempre viene en la mejor forma, siempre ha dado grandes actuaciones y no puedo, es un error el que lo pueda subestimar. Un guerrero y viene, y lo estoy preparado para el mejor Manny posible.
So, Katia's question was, what your Dennis expects out of Manny considering the 25 month layoff between fights for him? And Jordani said that underestimating Manny Pacquiao is absolutely out of question. He's going to be ready. I expect the best Manny Pacquiao to be out there on the ring, and that's my premise. I have prepared to face the best, to be the best.
Thank you.
Gracias, Katia.
All right. Thank you, Katia. Our last question is going to come from Mark Lalanwala with Sporting News. Mark, please unmute yourself. You can ask your question.
Hey, Manny, because you've trained for Spence this entire time and because of this late opponent change and Ugas' aggressive style, how dangerous of a fight is this for you?
I think the only adjustment that I'm going to make is for this fight is the southpaw and the right-handed. So that's the only thing because Errol Spence is aggressive also. And Ugas is aggressive, so that's good. I mean, we can create more action in the ring. The fans will love it.
Thank you, Manny. And Ugas, Dennis, I'd like to pose a similar question to you. On such short notice, how much of a threat can you pose to Manny with your style?
Bueno, la pregunta de Mark es, ¿Qué tan amenazado, qué tanto te consideras como amenaza para Manny Pacquiao con tu estilo, considerando que también esta pelea es de último minuto?
Dime la parte final.
Considerando que esta pelea es de último minuto, ¿qué tan peligroso te consideras para Manny con tu estilo, además, tu estilo agresivo? Manny decía recién que él vos seas agresivo, de la misma manera que él esperaba que Spence sea agresivo.
Bueno, yo es un peleador que viene a pelear, un peleador que viene a dejarlo todo, a dejar todo esa noche ahí, la noche más grande de mi carrera. Comencé el boxeo a los 6 años. Pienso que lo que están apoyándome, pienso que no lo voy a decepcionar.
How much of a threat am I going to be? I can tell you that I'm not going to disappoint the fans that are supporting me. This is the most important fight of my life. I started fighting when I was 6 years old, dreaming of this. And I'm going to be ready to step up to the ring and give my all. I'm gonna leave it all inside the ring. And no matter what happens, that's gonna be my goal. Leave it all out there, and whatever happens, happens.
All right. Thanks very much, Mark. For the press that are inquiring about it, we are going to send around a recording of this after the fact. But for now, I'll turn it back over to Ray. We'll get the closing comments from the fighters and wrap it up.
All right. Thank you very much, Andrew. And thank you very much to the media for joining us. Don't forget Manny Pacquiao, your Dennis Ugas for the Welterweight Championship of the World next Saturday, August 21, T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas on Fox Sports BBC pay-per-view, brought to you by MP Promotions and TGB Promotions. Also, this from the odds maker standpoint, it opened up as a 2-1 favorite in favor of Manny Pacquiao. So the odds makers, at least when it opened up, they feel that it is going to be a rather close fight. We anticipate a great night of boxing next Saturday in Las Vegas. First of all, I will leave it up to your Dennis Ugas with final comments as he gets set to take on the 8th Division World Champion in Manny Pacquiao. And also for your Dennis, a message to the fans. Martín.
Jordanis, bueno, comentarios finales sobre enfrentar a Manny el sábado 21 y además un mensaje que le quiera dar a, que les quieras dar a todos los aficionados que te van a ver pelear tanto en Estados Unidos como en Cuba y alrededor del mundo.
Sí, que esto sea una gran pelea. Le vamos a regalar una gran pelea a todos los fanáticos. Quiero mandarle un mensaje especialmente a los cubanos. Esta lucha va dedicada a todos los hombres y mujeres que quieren un cambio para nuestro país, todos los hombres y mujeres que cada día luchan por la libertad en nuestro país. Esta lucha, voy a luchar con el corazón para dedicarle esa lucha a ese pueblo cubano con deseo de un cambio, a todos los hombres y mujeres que están luchando por la libertad de nuestro país.
I can guarantee that this is going to be an amazing fight. Both Manny and I will leave it all out there, and that's going to be our gift to the fans. And I also want to send a greeting to the fans in Cuba, sending my best to all the men and women that are fighting for freedom, that are fighting for change. And I'm going to leave my heart out there for you. And that's my promise.
All right. Thank you very much, your Dennis. And for Manny Pacquiao, the 8th Division World Champion, looking to once again take hold of his WBA Welterweight Championship as he takes on the champion, your Dennis Ugas. Manny, your thoughts as you get set to collide against your Dennis Ugas 10 days from now.
Thank you for this opportunity to promote the fight. I'd like to say to the fans, please watch this fight. That means it is going to be a good fight. I'm not taking lightly for Ugas. Ugas is he's a good fighter and he's aggressive. I'm sure we can create more action in the ring and make the fans happy. And don't miss it. It's going to be a good fight. And I hope to see you in Vegas on August 21. Thank you, everyone, and to all the media, press, for always supporting and promoting boxing.
Thank you very much to your Dennis Ugas and Manny Pacquiao, the 8th Division World Champion. Thank you to the media and thank you to all the PR members and all the members of the promotional staff involved. We appreciate it. We will see you next week in Las Vegas for Manny Pacquiao going head-to-head against your Dennis Ugas on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view. Have a great rest of your afternoon. We'll see you next week in the Fighting